Good evening to you all. Thank you for joining us this evening. My name is Nella Moupierre, and I am the Director of Programs for Girl Be Heard. We are based in Brooklyn, New York, and so I hope from wherever you're joining us from, you can feel the love. That was an inspiring and awesome song brought to us by DJ Private Ryan, Feel the Love. Well, we're certainly excited about having the show this evening. I am pleased and thrilled to be here in support of my colleagues in Girl Be Heard Trinidad and Tobago, and shortly they will be taking it away to walk us through what is going to be an excellent time of celebrating love, self-care, togetherness, and diversity. You're going to love the show. At this time, I want to welcome the incoming public affairs officer from the U.S. Embassy named Kirsten Mishner. Kirsten, please join us.
Thank you so much. Good evening. I am Kirsten Mishner. I am the new public affairs officer at the U.S. Embassy in Port of Spain, Trinidad and Tobago. I'm delighted to be here this evening, and I thank the staff of Girl Be Heard New York, Girl Be Heard TT, and the 2021 participants for inviting me this evening to the Love and Unity Girl Be Heard Trinidad and Tobago Unplugged event. Since 2016, the U.S. Embassy in Port of Spain has been a partner with Girl Be Heard Trinidad and Tobago. The embassy shares the vision of Girl Be Heard in support of a space for girls and young women in Trinidad and Tobago to develop leadership skills and become advocates for change in their communities. A space and training to create strong women, women who engage in their communities, women who engage about social justice issues affecting their communities and lives, and women who find solutions. This is my first cultural event in Trinidad and Tobago. I arrived at post not yet 2 weeks ago. I am absolutely delighted to be here. As a former student of Pan myself and a Pan player, it has been my dream of decades to come to TT and work and live and play and perform here alongside people of this rich, diverse, and fascinating culture. Through the performing arts, music, poetry and spoken word, we can reach each other through our shared humanity. Through the arts, we can truly connect, and therein lie the seeds of change and progress. I am honored to have been invited to your event this evening, and I'm so excited to hear what this group of smart, committed, and talented young women have to say. Thank you again for inviting me to spend this evening with you. Everyone, please enjoy the show.
Pleasant good day, everyone. My name is Pleasant good day, everyone. My
I am Akai Webster, Program Manager of Girl Be Heard here in Trinidad and Tobago. It is my pleasure to welcome you to this year's Unplugged show entitled Love and Unity. While we regret that the COVID pandemic prevented us from holding a face-to-face show, we are excited about the opportunities of holding an inspiring, engaging virtual show for yet another year. This year, we are pleased to include participants from East, West, North, and South Trinidad, and three participants from our sister isle, Tobago. The diverse uniqueness of each of our participants will be showcased today. You will experience the love and unity of our wonderful Twin Island Caribbean as our talented participants speak their truth of identity and leadership through spoken word, poem, and song. Having said that, I would like to take this opportunity to thank our supporters and sponsors, Girl Be Heard USA, the Oak Foundation, Be Entertainment, and the U.S. Department of State to the U.S. Embassy in Port of Spain. I purposely left the embassy for last because I'd like to welcome the new public affairs officer, Kirsten McChenna, to Trinidad and Tobago. We look forward to meeting you when things are relaxed, and we hope that you'll become addicted to the love and unity that our Twin Island have to offer. So everyone, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. I now introduce you to our host of today's show, our TAs. They are storytellers, poets, authors, actors. Please welcome Veronique Francois and Ariel John. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Hello, hello, hello. Good evening, everyone.
We are, as was mentioned, we are the TAs, or teaching artists, of the Girl Be Heard Trinidad and Tobago 2021 cohort. My name is Veronique Francois.
And my name is Ariel John.
And we are so happy to have you here. These girls are really, really talented, and we are excited to showcase what they have done throughout the beginning of this program till now. Big us up in the chat now. Tell us where you're from. Arima, Port of Spain, let us know. Let's keep the vibes flowing because we are going to have a great, great time this evening. Let me see y'all. Let me see y'all. Tell me where y'all from in the chat.
Waiting to see.
Waiting to see. I don't know if our okay, okay. NYC. Nice. I guess we only have people from USA. All right, St. James, El Dorado. Lovely. So we have people from all over here. I see them at Arima. Nice. I'll say he's from the place to live. The best place to live is Tobago. I guess he was mentioning
San Francisco.
San Francisco. Very nice. Mm-hmm. Awesome. So we are really happy to have all of you here, and we are going to have a great, great evening. I proclaim it. We are going to have a great, great
Absolutely. Today. Beautiful. And our girls have been incredibly excited for this evening. For most of them, this is their first time ever, their debut performance for a community audience, for their friends and family and loved ones. And so we really celebrate them this evening. And we're gonna get straight into it, right? One of the really beautiful things about this evening is that the girls have told us about themselves in their own words. So first up, for this evening, we have the incredible Princess Foster. She's an aspiring writer who uses realistic events to motivate her while she strives for justice for all. Just like her name says, she's royalty. She is Princess Foster. Everyone, help me to welcome in the chat. You can drop some emojis, drop some flames, anything. Drop, you know, the little confetti thing for Princess Foster.
Pleasant good day, everyone. My name is Princess Foster, and the piece I will be performing is entitled, A Brave Space Is to Me. A brave space. So you're the one that can help me achieve my goals. You're the one everyone likes. Why should I believe that I can reach far with you? My sea of space makes me happy. I don't even have any worries. But I need to be proud of me. I can't hide forever, so I'll come join you. Because with risk, there is reward. And I believe that this risk will be rewarded. I know everyone may have their opinions, But that's okay, because I know my worth. So I will be brave and show that even in a brave space, you can still be safe. Because this is me. This is real. I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be, living my life in society.
Big up to Princess. Let me see what we say in the chat there. Big up to Princess. This is me. This is exactly where I'm supposed to be. Lovely, lovely stuff. As I said before, and you will continue to hear me say, these girls are really, really talented. And I can't wait to share, because we have been in this program for about 10 weeks and we have seen the immense talent that these girls have. And we are so happy to share it with you all today. Something that Princess mentioned is a brave space. And just a little insight on what the program, the Girl Be Heard Trinidad and Tobago program is like. We have two units. The first unit, the pieces that you would see are based on this first unit that deals with identity and a little bit of leadership. And we spoke a lot about what brave spaces are. And this here, the ability to share their work and be vulnerable is a brave space. And I really want to thank Princess for that. Let's move right along. So next we have a young lady. She is 14 years old and she has a big voice. She's a person who can change the world with her winning smile. God's strength. This is Gabrielle McDonald, a future songwriter just waiting to be heard. Let's give it up in the chat for Gabrielle McDonald.
I am by Gabrielle McDonald. I am strong, capable of doing anything. A person who can hold up the weight of anything, including but not limited to struggles. I am powerful. I aspire to attain knowledge that will bring understanding to my conviction, enabling me to persevere, not to be influenced, but to influence. I am beautiful, made in the image and likeness of God, His masterpiece. I am unique and special, made in a way that only I can be me. The only me there is, and the only me there ever will be. I am kind and helpful, always willing to help those in need while showing them a sense of compassion. I am hardworking, always striving to do the best in everything that I do, achieving high standard and quality. I am a girl, a young woman in society who will break the perception of being incapable or weak. For the weakness you see is failing, for strength is in the making. I am rich in melanin and proud of it. I may be judged by society for the color of my skin, but only He can truly judge me. I am a child of God, brought onto this earth with a purpose to add something beneficial to this world. I am alive and well, waking up every morning ready to make good of the good times and better of the sad times. Entering the fresh new day with a smile, hoping for the best in everything. I am healthy. Healthy physically and mentally, with a positive viewpoint and a smile. I am a human just like you, a human with feelings and emotions, one who makes mistakes and learns from them, a human on the journey of life. I am me. I am Gabrielle McDonald.
Wow,
Yes, Gabby. Good day. I love it. Such a powerful thing to have students go from, you know, seeing this little Zoom boxing session, and then, you know, they come up with these really powerful performances full of like gusto and like breath and soulful. It's really important for us within the program that the girls affirm who they are in the world, affirm the realities that they are creating, and also affirm each other as well, so that, you know, they congratulate each other, they gossip each other at any given moment. So that's also part of our culture creating inside of Girlbehood Trinidad and Tobago. And up next in our beautiful listing today, we have none other than Janelia Samaru, who is an upcoming singer and poet. She seeks to have her voice heard throughout the entire world, and she enjoys performing. Determined and persistent to achieve her goals and to be the best person that she can be, I need a little light of the chat for Janelia Samaru.
Guys, my name is Janelia Samaru. I'll be presenting one of my poems I've written so far. So here's how it goes. I'm just a girl out there in the world full of hate, lies, betrayals, and deception. That's why some of my circles be small, so I can't heal myself. And yet still, I want to find out my identity. I'm an upcoming artist. I'm an upcoming poet. I love to dance, and I love to let my voice be heard. But I wonder why the world be full of hate. I just want to be myself. I am black. Is it a crime? Stop judging against us black people. Our black people just want to be in a world full of love and affection. All I want is a nation of peace, unity, and teamwork. Us coming together to make a change.
Big up yourself, Janelia. Peace, unity, and teamwork. Us coming together to make a change. Very strong words from Janelia there. See her lighting up herself in the y'all. Just give Janelia some love in the chat, please. Definitely. Remember what I said about the talented girls that we have, and we're seeing a wide range of them today. As Janelia spoke about love, unity, and teamwork, I just want to mention yet again our sponsors who have partnered with us with this project, with this Girlbehood Trinidad and Tobago project. The U.S. Embassy of Trinidad and Tobago, the Oak Foundation, and B Entertainment, our parent company here in Trinidad and Tobago, right? So I just wanted to light up our sponsors, because without them, we will not be here. All right. Are y'all enjoying the show so far? If y'all enjoying the show so far, let me know in the chat. Let me know if people say yes, yes. I see some people coming in, yay. Yes, and we have some more. Strong start, lovely. We have so much more in store for y'all today. So moving right along, we have another young lady coming up. Her name is Hope Wilson. And this is what Hope says about herself. Hope, the girl worth more than a ruby. Weighs more than a gem. Giving hope to young girls is part of her hobby. Precious flower, she blossomed to be. Y'all, give it up for Hope Wilson.
Hi, everyone. My name is Hope Wilson, and my piece is based on leadership style. I was 3 years old when I realized my leadership style was created by teamwork. Hard work and commitment pushed to the front of the line, whereas that time team members dropped their focus and merely went on with life. I skipped my meals, rejected my health, wondering if they care how I felt. But anyhow, this girl rapidly picked up their slack. Soul open for the opportunity of new learning. Mind and eyes literally focused on the prize, waiting for chance in life. High tolerance for the words that are shot at me one by one. She now going and reaching away. Look how she dressing. I don't have to listen to she. In spite of the words, I kept my head up high, sleepless nights, but there's never true punctuality behind the line. Communication shows as a super system, the proper use of intellect, formally speaking, I can't help myself. But this is driven by passion, which is a reason to mentally keep calm, up and ready to create unity based on trust, love, not by watching others and miserably ruin lust. The way in which jealousy tempted persons to use their feet to make me fall, I guess they never realized I fall to stand tall. Bygones are bygones, they get shaken up like dust. Proudly modeling and having fun by my family, lined up myself to take risks. Earn my growth and receive greatness. Sure, got no time to take advantage of that great pleasure that they call power. That's not worth fighting over. So I'll just be myself and have respect for others, live by prosperity, and do my personal choice. This motivational leader that will share positivity using her voice. Thank you.
So beautiful. Thank you so much, Hope, coming in with the motivational manifesto for us this evening. You know, one of the beautiful things about this season of online learning and distance learning and gathering in this way is that, you know, previously we would have had the Girl Behood cohort coming from one particular school. However, because it's now opened up to all, you know, students of Trinidad and Tobago, all young women, young girls of Trinidad and Tobago, we have such a beautiful mix of people coming from all different corners, all different walks of life, with so much to offer in the classroom. And I think so far you've been seeing a really wonderful representation of that as well. Up next, I'd like to welcome another incredible writer, Anyawa Adams. And in her words, she says, one, she is Anyawa. Yes, Anyawa. As encouraging as she is kind. Two, her dream, to soar with others, to enjoy the journey, not the destination. Three, her writing is used as another's voice with a strong intention for all of us being heard. Folks, can you please give some love in the chat section to Anyawa Adams.
I am Anyawa Adams, and I am a part of the Girls We Heard program. My piece will be on identity, finding oneself and being empowered. You are bright. That's right, an luminous light. Take flight, shine, for you are divine. Just as sweet as wine, be proud to say, yes, I am mine. You are beautiful, a wonderful creation, an amazing thought of imagination that Almighty has created. Be elated, for it has been stated, declared, that I am not weak but strong. The idea of me was never wrong. I am perfect. A survivor, a giver, a liver, a first place winner. I am someone. I am bright.
Brilliant. Thank you so much, Anyawa, for that beauty and for that declaration of self. Really incredibly powerful. At this point in the program, we are going to highlight or at least get some direct live feedback from one of our participants. So I'm going to invite Avari Mahabir to supply us with some participant remarks. Avari, are you there?
Hello, good evening. I'm having a bit of trouble with my camera. But never mind.
All right.
Okay.
Yay, we can see your face now. Wonderful.
Good evening,
fantastic.
Everyone.
Good evening. Awesome. So you've, you know, this is your first time in the program, and it's been just about 10 weeks that we've been together, learning together and growing together. What has been your general experience of the program so far?
So far in the program, this program has mostly helped me change my way of writing and actually helped me connect with my poetry. When I write, I feel a bit of an emotional connection to my writing because I'm writing what I feel and what I think about. It helps me express myself a lot more because before I'll just be quiet and I would just try to write something, but it wouldn't come to me. Girlbehood TT has mostly helped me open up to my friends and family a bit more, and it has helped me to keep calm in tough situations as well.
Wow, that's a handful. So you're saying it helps you with your writing, it helps you develop a sense of calm, as well as it has made you more brave to like operate in your space, your family space, your community space. That's really beautiful, Avari. Thank you for that. Were there any particular moments that stand out for you in the program, or even something you would have learned in the program so far that the old Avari 10 weeks ago didn't know, or like, you know, is discovering?
That so many girls around Trinidad and Tobago like to write as well. It was surprising.
Mm-hmm. Right. So is it that you didn't have, you didn't know that that kind of community existed before? This is new.
No.
To you. Okay. Awesome. Well, this is brief. We thank you, Avari, for coming in and sharing some little tidbits with us and sharing about your experience. Thank you so much. I'm going to hand over to Veronique now.
Definitely, definitely. And, you know, in this particular cohort, we have our wide age range going on. Avari is 13, and we have girls way up to 18 in our program. And today, we're going to see... Well, right now we're going to see another participant on the further end of the age spectrum, and her name is Sierra. Number one, her passion is becoming a chef, but putting pen to paper and making a difference by speaking out is her biggest aspiration. Although considered a shy young lady, the camera loves her natural talent. And trust me, it can be easily displayed on screen, as you will see. Give it up, put your keys together, put your Zoom keys together, everyone, for Sierra Hernandez.
So you think this is a game, huh? Leading astray your feelings, that whenever they're painting me like I have no color but despair, like a dog with a leash only you have, you think I'm nothing without you by my side. I get it. You think I'm broken, nothing more than glass sitting into sand, like a piece of land that no one wants to enter but you. You think I can break into millions of pieces and call at your command. I'm under a spell that trapped my soul into a bottle with the hands rubbing to release you and give you three wishes. One, make you very, very happy. Two, never ever cheat. Three, no matter how many times your fist reaches my face, I stay. Because once I leave, I'm selfish and worthless, words clouding my judgment, allowing you to magically break down my walls with your fist and repair them with materials because I'm materialistic. Right. Hello, Mr. Misogynistic, that allows you to fix those thoughts into your cranium, treating women like ragdolls and toys, good for play, easy to break, who consistently thinks that women are of cooking, cleaning, don't mention sleeping, but I'm here to sadly give you your mistaken calculations to believe that feminists don't strike back. To think I will allow you to make me feel sinful or toxic. See, you call us garden tools of all sorts, but when it's retaliated against, you become vulgar. We are gold diggers if we talk to a man for money. What about when you talk to a girl for her body? Scary, right? How I have the power to give you examples as to how you treat us? But... that's not power, but life. See, you're so ignorant, you can barely understand your narcissistic ways and your plan to think that I will stay for your objects and prize because that's better than freedom and life. So, let's get it straight. I am not your genie. Your three wishes have now been revoked. A powerful, strong woman has spoken and you cannot respond because you are wrong and broken. Thank you.
Yeah, go on, song. I'm seeing the chat blowing up with that. Mm-hmm. I'm seeing them blowing up. And what talent, you see, I did not lie. what talent we have here.
The truth.
Definitely. Ariel, tell me something. You know, we've been in this program for 2 months and something. What would you say is like the high point of being a teaching artist with this cohort of GBHTV?
Right. Apart from these participants this year being incredibly talented, one of the like heart-centered moments for me would be during our check-ins when we start this year, where the girls often choose to be very vulnerable about how they're feeling, about what made them feel that way, about just like their circumstances or situations on any given day. And that then gives other girls permission to do the same. And so we've created this kind of, you know, trust circle, if you will. And it's just really beautiful to experience this building of community. And I really find that as vibes, because that's the place for me that healing happens. So that's right. My point for the program.
Definitely.
What do you think about, what is your high point for the program?
You know, I know you're going through that question.
That's right.
for me, I think definitely, as you said, the camaraderie, the togetherness of this particular group. And one of the things that always lights up my day that makes me smile is that before and after a session, before and after we have something going on, we always see the WhatsApp group light up. And they talk and they interact with each other, which I find amazing, because we took these young ladies from all over Trinidad and Tobago. Most of them did not know each other from before. Mm-hmm. And then they could come together within this kind of sisterhood and interact in this wonderful, loving way. It's crazy. So that is one of the high points for me in this particular program.
Absolutely. Yes. And so as we continue with the program for this evening, we are shifting over to one of our Tobagonian newcomers, the powerhouse that is Ayoma Strong George. Light it up in the chat for Ayoma.
Pleasant good afternoon, everyone. My name is Ayoma Strong George. I'm a 13-year-old singer-songwriter from Trinidad and Tobago. And this afternoon, I am honored to be doing a piece for you entitled Pollution. Enjoy! Right now, I'm leading a lyrical resolution to stop the pollution in order to preserve Mother Nature's evolution. Come on, people, connect, jump on board to this green eco-preservation. You don't need no transportation. It's a green spiritual vibration. Tell me why we had to wait for government intervention to draft up legislation and come up with a solution to enshrine it in our constitution. Come on, snap out of your destructive illusion. So you don't see that the carbon and environmental contamination has a rippling adverse effect causing severe destruction. Oh Lord, why we can't see that we are killing Mother Nature? Even Barron said it. Mother Earth is crying. She said to stop the polluting. Oi, oi, oi. Mother Earth is dying. We got to stop the polluting. Oi, oi, oi. I'm pleading, people, it's time to see that we have an untidy community. Our pollution is causing depletion of our vital natural resources in our environment. We humans produce too much pollution. Tell me why we can't live in harmony and enjoy our God-given vegetation. Just note, this was a divine inspirational intervention and not just any petty little demonstration. Thank you.
Big up, Ayoma. I see in the chat blowing up for this piece. And yes, it was filmed using the ancient backdrop and stuff. Well, Tobago, somebody say, what do you expect, right? Amazing, amazing talent. And that's what kind of we're here about at Girl Be Heard, you know, activism. And the name of our program this evening is Love and Unity. Love for ourselves, unity with others, and also love for the planet, you know. Thank you, Ayoma, for bringing out that really, really important message about how we treat our environment. Amazing stuff, guys. Y'all enjoying yourself? Are y'all enjoying yourself this evening? I want to see all your lights up in chat. Are y'all enjoying yourself? Yes, yes, yes. I see some people in chat. Amazing, amazing stuff. Moving right along. So we have our next participant, and I'm going to read what she says. All right? I'm going to try to do her work justice. She says, hey, this is Mercedes. No, not the dream Benz, but she is driven by a dream to see young women dare to be. She lives in a world of not only land and sea, but of career. She has a Spanish term here. She's into languages and stuff, but anybody who know me know that I'm not good with languages. But anyway, it says in English, if there's a will, there is a way. This girl hopes to take you on a journey further than our reality. For she thinks we're all worthy of destination harmony. Ladies and gentlemen, let's buckle our seatbelts as we travel with Mercedes through poetry.
Her inner being. Through her eyes full curiosity, each time she knocked upon that door marked opportunity, seeing you at the darkest hour. The moon's ecliptic view illuminating the part. She was tired. But this fighter was too resilient. A half-filled cup couldn't suffice her thirst for more. She had to see the water's edge at the glass's brim. The winds whispered, time to close your shutters. But this girl saw something. The fine gold writing between the lines, the finish line running unsolicited with a heart pounding of faithfulness. An appetite, for she saw herself at this generation's summit of greatness. On her playground, the bullies would attack, but she'd always bounce back beneath her rays, mask beneath her rays, with bruises from other days. Wait, yes, she knows you'd hear her sing of, good day in my mind, safe to take a sip out, get some air now, let your edge out, too soon I spoke bruises that left scars to remind her of those parts, of the parts they played, thinking of the impact they made. Instead, all they did was throw stones at her window pane. Don't worry. She still spread her wings and took off with the remaining pixie dust, for she preferred to be endured by such miraculous wanderlust, though to some her hope sounded rather fictitious. However, through her lens, it was being the nomad instead of going mad. The anger, the shroud, made no sense wasting time behind any of the sort. Even when they sang cry, cry, baby, walla, walla, dumpling, she grew immensely and ran up that mountain relentlessly to that epitome marked destiny. Even when sometimes blocked by the gust of the wind, even when she tripped and lost sight of that image, slipped and into the valley, down the stream, thinking that this was going to be the end of the journey to a dream that she's been working for what seemed like eternity. Ah! Why? Why me? He whispered. As long as the fate you possess is even as small as a mustard seed. Onto her knees and back onto her feet, once more she trodden, using the feet as the stairs and no longer being pushed back into that dark corner of fear. So just a little side note. Dear me, Don't let the unknown intimidate you, for as a wise soul once told you, what to be will be. Keep striving. Only shed if it's to blossom and reach beyond the galaxies. For the way I've seen your garden grow throughout this journey, every day, whether good or bad, can be your greatest epiphany.
Thank you so much for that poem, Mercedes. The adults on this call, I don't know if you remember when you were a teenager, and I don't know if you remember being that level of self-aware or that level of being able to reflect on your life and give yourself advice, which is one of the really beautiful things about our young people that we have in this program. They know a lot about themselves, and they're not here to waste time. And in sharing their voice in, which doesn't always have to be in shouting or dominating a space. It could come, power could show up as these really tender moments as well. And I think Mercedes gives a really wonderful example of that. And to extend on that kind of vibe and to build the idea of voice as power, I'd like to introduce our next performer, who says that she is a warrior by spirit, lover by soul, child of the elders' tribe, change to be. Brought upstage on the wings of creativity, she is Cheyenne Calliste. Enjoy.
A pleasant good afternoon to everyone. My name is Cheyenne Calliste, and today I will be performing for you my identity-based spoken word poem entitled Thoughts on Tone. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, do hope you guys enjoy and appreciate. Thank you very much. I am not broken. I've just lost a part of me. She sails away from my knowing atoms beyond my believing, but she is free. She is free. Yet I wake out of those nightmares into lucid dreams, watching her speak as if she knew what those puns mean. I am the vague allusion to her poetry, though we are more like simile. She denies the likeness of our construction now. My surface seems numb, but my arteries do feel empty, victims of anxiety. But it's okay. Euphoria is a breath away, so I tend to smile when I bleed. It could only get better. Soon my jaw will adapt to applaud those jokes with laughter. She avoids attention with humor, a component of her defense mechanism. She stands in the light, but opaque surfaces suffer refraction. She's tinted by secrets ignorantly. She puts proverbs on display, but those sayings only mask her vile things. Hardly do they ever cure her sins. She endures instances that merge with her rigid reflection that made her iris into a pit. Violent vibrations she often attracts, but this time her ribcage doesn't contract. Relax. I would have said I was okay if you asked. Take a moment to adore the perfection. Purpose is precision. Pain is but an extraction to the manual's opposition. So my dear presence, don't dismiss the whole for a fraction. What's the matter? Don't you know that you matter? This is your space to occupy. You are porous yet congested in your mind. What does that tell you? My dear, open your eyes. Forget about being forgotten. No need to be bound by what's happened. You are more than an antonym to their perception. You are creation. Though as a sinner you repent, as an anointed you shall come to know resurrection. So sleep easy, my love. For it has been a hard dream. But rise like in luminous spirits. For this is merely the thorn contrasting the rose's beauty. And though you fear she shall come to perish, my love, you should know she will be with the blossom buds of tomorrow. See, faith is the cliche that names this sequence. Though she may not coincide with our current states of mind on the graph of life, healing is but the responding variable to time. So let not hasty horizons divide your skies. Pay homage to what you feel, but don't deprive your feet of mobility. By pride, your shoulders shall come to elevate. Now you shall know of grandiose taste. For though I have hurt you, my inner warrior, have taught me of depth greater than wombs, air beyond these fumes. Now no sinister forces dare whisper upon my neurons, for now I am strong. Now I am strong. Those ways were walked, lies heard, but the truth has been spoken. By grace, I have been lifted of all burden. Those splinters at my feet are shattered. But I am not broken. Thank you very much.
Pick up yourself. Pick up yourself, Cheyenne. I like that line, and I am not broken. I love it. I love it. I see the chat blowing all the way up. You all know we have a theater-based program, right? For this dramatics. It's part of it. It's part of it, man. Yes, yes. Everybody blowing up in the chat. Amazing, amazing, amazing talent that we have here this evening. I want to bring on Mercedes. I want to bring her on live now. Mercedes, are you there?
Yes, I am indeed.
Lovely, lovely. Mercedes, I've got some questions for you. But first, before I bring those questions, tell me what was that phrase that you wrote in your bio in Spanish that I completely 100%
Oh my goodness, you messed it up. But good effort. Good effort.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
It's querer es poder. It's a Spanish proverb, which means where there's will, there's a way.
Lovely, lovely, amazing. Thank you very much. So I have a few questions for you. First, being we've been in this program for a while. What would you say is the high point of the program thus far for you?
Oh, that's an easy one. Well, as I should say, as we say in class, my rose.
Yes,
rose, I would say. It's just being there, you know, being there. It's a wonderful experience being able to improve in my poetry and my art that I provide to evoke that emotion that I want my audience to feel within whenever I'm presenting. I think I really improved within that aspect for sure. So I really like that. And you all encourage us a lot. There's a lot of encouragement. I saw as well with my peers, the way they've grown also, like it's their confidence and so on. So it's just amazing. Really and truly.
Definitely, definitely. I think that we saw that with your piece. It was very reaching out to the audience. I think Ariel mentioned that as well. My other question for you is, I want you to pretend now that you're the marketing person now for Girl Be Heard. How would you market this program? What is the selling point of this GBHTT, this Girl Be Heard program for you? Talk to me.
All right. Well, a small thing now, like I'm the Instagram ambassador, as we say nowadays, for the Girl Be Heard. Let's get it going. Okay, so I would say to young girls, one thing for sure that we do within this program is that we provide that free space and platform to take the band-aid off the issue, to not be afraid to express things that our society always likes to mask behind. Like, no, we don't do that. We are very vulnerable in what we're saying. We're very free. We are open and honest in whatever we're saying. And I love that. And it's all through a very creative way. So, and you get to make new friends, trust me, that you would never think you would have spoken to ever. So.
I'm sure that we can see the camaraderie, especially like in the chat now, we can see a lot of encouragement, as you said, going on. Thank you very much, Mercedes, for your comments and remarks.
I hope you all enjoy the rest of the show, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, and we are moving right along in this evening's proceedings. Up next, we have the indomitable Monique Smart. In her words, she's a girl who writes what's on her mind, a girl who is very precious and has a smart brain of creation, a girl with many powerful words, a brilliant writing wizard. Folks, help me to welcome Monique Smart.
Hi, my name is Monique, and today I'm going to present a poem called Leadership. I hope you all enjoy. Democratic leadership is my leadership style. You see, there's no I in team. This is about working together, not just to believe in a tree. But one, there's not more strength, but the improvement, help, and strategy, there's dignity. No, I'm not a quitter. I am a leader. I hear people's ideas, but I make the final decision. Achievements and goals, I hear these whispering on because they are important. Stand together as a team as we get the job done. Teamwork is very important to me. It brings out cooperation and a special mentality. If you can believe in yourself, you can achieve anything. Let's get the job done. There is no I in the word team. Be a leader, not a quitter, because I believe with courage, help, and cooperation, we can achieve the fantasy. I hear ideas on what people want to say. I don't ignore what is being said. Teamwork makes dream work. I live in a plan, but not just the planet, but I want to achieve it. The job needs to be accomplished, not to be put on hold. Remember, don't be a quitter, be a powerful leader.
Wonderful, wonderful. Don't be a quitter, be a powerful leader. As I mentioned before, you know, in this unit that we dealt with a lot of identity and leadership styles. So you see that coming out in some of the pieces here this evening. One thing I wanted to mention, Monique and Hope, they were also part of the 2020 cohort. And I wanted to mention that because I see that there are a good bit of Girl We Heard alumni here this evening. Big up on yourself in the chat. Big up on yourself. I think I saw Jada and Hannah, members of the first Girl We Heard program here in Trinidad and Tobago. Yes, Tahira, I see you. Yes. Right. So when you become part of the Girl We Heard program, it's not just about the few months that we have you and we take you through this program, but you become part of this family, this Girl We Heard alumni. And you really get that encouragement from the past members. And we hope to have this program, of course, moving from strength to strength for years to come. So I just wanted to mention as well, it was the vision of Girl We Heard New York that came down to this tiny island state of Trinidad and Tobago and saw the potential, saw the talent of these girls and decided to invest their time here. And we are so grateful for that partnership. Now I want to bring on somebody that you heard a little bit earlier before. Her name is Avari. And in her own words, she says, she wants to be heard throughout the world. She's 13 years old. She sometimes escapes reality with a poem or a song. She can be very good. Her name is Avari. Put your Zoom hands together for Avari Maharir.
My name is Avari Mahabir, and I will be reciting Help Me. To me, a brave space is stepping out of my comfort zone and being proud of myself, or holding my head up high, even as the words of hatred and discrimination try to drown me in their sea. But something pushes me away from that. Something I can't describe. gosh. What's it called? It's at the top of my mind. Fear. That's the word. Fear seems to control me. Hatred said that it loves me and doesn't want to let me go. I really want to be on my own, but my family scares me. Holding me back from being myself. I'm different from the shadows that try to consume me, but I'm trying to be a light when they hate it. Yet people lie to love me. Talking will help, but to who? To myself. I really don't know what to do, but then I say to myself, stop it! Say something else! You're sleeping! Wake up! You're lying to yourself! That's not okay. That is really not okay. With support from my friends, they'll tell me the truth. They'll carry me from place from where I fell. But helping me to be courageous and step out into a brave space. That is a place filled with no hate. I'm free. I'm fine. I can be me. All the time.
I'm free, I'm fine, I could be me all the time. Words to live by from Avari Mahabir, who we heard from a bit earlier. And we're actually, you know, winding down in this evening's program. And our next performer, who is actually our final performer for this evening, before we go into another thing, we have a surprise for you. Our final performer for this evening goes by the name of Jada McLeod. She is a writer whose work reflects stories embracing being a Black young woman. She aims to provide power spaces for youth to thrive and be themselves. She lives by the motto, let's talk youth, let's talk you. Folks, you have to blow up the chat section because this is the last person and we've seen so much beautiful talent this evening. Help me to welcome Jada McLeod.
Hi, my name is Jada McLeod and today I'll be performing a new poem I wrote entitled A Melanated Identity, That Black Girl. The genesis of the Black woman, who I am without saying I am, the origins of the Black girl. My history, a culture once well known, lost, and found in the way I wear my hair. The kinks and curls that say with a sneer, I dare, my dear, hello. My name is a Black girl. Identity. The girl you treat like the bane of your existence, when in reality, her presence is your life's evidence. I've been made to hide my truth when I'm around you, like you do when you stand in front of a mirror. The way you look down to hide full lips and bow down in belief of lies about your growing hips, the rumor of your intelligence, whilst making you their main influence, Black woman, you are it. Look back at yourself as a Black girl, as me, and know you are it. Identity. The age of the Black woman is in ascendancy respectfully. It's time to remember that our identity is shaped by a line of powerful queens. Don't act like you're below anyone by any means. And it's not lost on me anymore. And I hope we continue to tell ourselves this as we grow and believe it as our call. That our history A culture once well known, lost and found in the way we stand up tall and say with a sneer, I dare, my dear hello. Our name is That Black Girl.
Wow, people, I want you to give, watch me just blow the chat all the way up for our participants this evening. Just blow the chat up, please. Mm-hmm. You know, of course, like if we were in live, we would say, you know, let's get a round of applause. Let's get a virtual round of applause in the chat for all of our participants. You know, I must mention that there were a few participants that did not participate in this show, but will definitely be participating in the following show. And I see them in the chat. I see them here this evening, Winriva and Naima. So definitely, definitely, we look out to seeing them in our later show, our show later on this year. And of course, we expect to see all of you at that show as well. But don't leave just here, because we have something really, really exciting that we want to do with you. Of course, we saw all of these amazing young ladies, and they are really talented. But I know that there are some talented people here in the audience tonight. And Ariel, I think so.
I think so too, yes.
We are going to write what we're going to call a community poem, right? Now, I'm going to give you the instructions here. Let's bring up the prompt. If you get it on the screen, that'll be really great. Right, so our prompt this evening is, this is what unity looks like. So what we're asking you to do is we're asking you to write one line, just one line, yeah, people, one line based on this prompt, this is what unity looks like. I'm just gonna give you all like 2 minutes to do it. Just think of a line, just one line. And then Ariel and I will read it in a dramatic fashion, and we will read our community poem that we have created in this wonderful virtual space. So we're waiting patiently, we're giving you all 2 minutes, we're waiting patiently to see what lines y'all could come up with. Use your metaphors, your similes, you know, throwing some personification there. We all know what I'm talking about. And let us write a piece together. So I can read one, and then you can read one. How about that? And
we sounds can, good to me. Know, like, group poem.
There you go. All right, let me see. Togetherness in alignment with our global sisters. Wow.
I'm gonna give a few seconds.
Number one in all the race, gal. Could never replace.
So much fun.
All right, let us read our community poem. So I'll start. Together in alignment with our goals.
Global sisters?
Global sisters. Sorry, I tried. Let me start. Awesome. Together in alignment with our global sisters.
Community support and love.
Unity is school children running for burger box lunch. Love that.
This is what unity looks like. You see it every day. The way the trees sway as the wind whistles by, together they go. None of the leaves left behind.
Unity, taking each other's hand, guiding them to safety. Love that.
Coming as one to join with our whole nation.
Definitely. The forbearance of our ancestors diffused down our bloodline, even when our lives are on the line. Wow, who goes from?
All right, it looks like you, it looks like me, people of La Trinity.
Lovely. It is our faith with love.
Hand in hand, we support one another to let our voices be heard.
Unity is more than quantity. To me, it is the quality we each cherish in each other.
Helping the helper in times of need, that's the way we proceed.
It is the togetherness of our brothers and sisters, one blood, one love, one family.
Together we aspire, together we can achieve greatness.
It encases our soul, for we are not meant to live alone.
The Good Samaritans, people we meet.
Unity, where I feel loved and welcome, we are one.
It's our passion in the way we treat with one another. How we support and uplift each other.
United, we can move a mountain, climb over any obstacle, and make a change. United, we stand.
Strength in numbers.
Brothers and sisters by blood and by love, growing and glowing together with a mindset of positivity.
Helping, not hurting.
Unity is a state of togetherness, like the wind, the rain, and the sky, harmonizing nature in its fullest.
We are our brothers' keeper.
As we unearth the vibration that connects us to our motherland, we blossom in unity.
A reflection of reality, mirroring the color red. Because where we come from, no matter, all our weeders bleed the same color.
Unity is strength, and strength in the power of the people, or an organization or movement. And that is the end. Wow, Ariel Gill. People go take a while. These people are amazing.
They're outside.
I'm telling you. Yeah, guys, thank you so much. Thank you so much for participating in our group, our community poem. Some of y'all should be part of the Year Behind program. Y'all are so talented, and we are so happy that you are engaging with us. Ariel, I think that's the end of our job here tonight.
My job's done. So before we go, I believe is Nella coming to say a few words?
Yes, I think Nella is coming. That's why I said, what's up, then? You sure the face, we're gonna add the water, Nella. And definitely thank you so much for listening and participating.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everyone. Please, please, please join me in giving a warm, enthusiastic applause to Veronique and Ariel, who were our MCs for this evening. Thank you both. They are the TAs for the Girl Be Heard Trinidad and Tobago team. They were amazing. GBHTT participants, that was spectacular. The insights that you all shared with us, the authenticity, the vulnerability, the passion, the power, I am filled this evening. I'm glad I spent my Friday night with you all. I want to again thank the GBHTT team, Akai, Ariel, Veronique, and all the participants. Thank you so much, Kirsten, for joining us this evening. And I believe I saw Gail too. Thank you for your continued support. I certainly want to give a shout out to the GBH crew, New York, who's here this evening, myself included. Olivia's been behind the scenes. This was wonderful. And as we were mentioning earlier today, it's only halfway. We've only been involved in programming with this cohort, with GBHTT, for the past, I think, 10 weeks. Can you imagine what the show is going to look like when they culminate? It's going to be spectacular, because as they continue week to week, there's going to keep building on these conversations that they're having, going into power, privilege, and oppression. They're going to start and continue developing these artistic skills, this ability to really use their art to amplify these issues that they're passionate about. So I am so looking forward to everything you all have coming to us for the end of program show. But until then, continue following, supporting these young people here at GBHTT. Listen to their voices. They are the future, and our future is bright. Thank you for joining us this evening. Everybody have a wonderful evening.